But let me start by first going across to Mr. Adi Godrej to get a sense of what this Supreme Court opinion really means for the economy. Mr. Godrej, clearly a big relief coming for the government, but what does it really mean for the economy? Clearly, it has far-reaching implications.
I think it is a very balanced judgment. I welcome it. CII was asked to provide its opinion when the government made this precedential reference by the Supreme Court, which the CII did. And our argument basically was that auction is the preferred method, but not the only method. It cannot work for all natural resources. And I think the Supreme Court judgment very clearly was on the line CII had suggested. We had also said that where auction is not the route the government or the executive may decide, it should be transparent and fair, and that the judiciary should come into the picture only if the transparency and fairness is not maintained, which again I believe is the gist of the judgment.
Mr. Godrej, the fact that you had the judiciary in its 2nd February judgment actually saying that, you know, here on auction is what should be the preferred route for natural resources, of allocation of natural resources, that also brought in a larger concern on part of corporate India as well as foreign investors. The blurring of lines between policy making by the executive as well as the role of the judiciary, with fears really coming in that any policy which is made by the government can actually be struck down by courts. At least, has today's opinion helped bring relief on that front?
Yes, I think there is certainly clarity. I think the Supreme Court is clearly saying that constitutional provisions will prevail and that the executive has to have a role in deciding on how natural resources are to be allocated. And I think the clarification is very good. And to our mind, I think it will be good for business in the future. It will be good for economic development in the future.
So staying with the entire economic development, there's also the larger issue of revenue maximization versus public good, a debate that has especially crept up in the context of recent CAG reports and the 2G scam or Colgate. The fact that the Supreme Court opinion today makes it clear that revenue maximization cannot be the only motive, in a way also upholds the government's views and questions the CAG's methodology of simply taking revenue maximization as the sole objective.
Yes, well, revenue maximization, revenue, I would say the word should be revenue optimization, is very important. Because, for example, if you get a very large revenue in the sale of a natural resource, for example, and later on that business is not successful, the tax collection of the government would be low, and that wouldn't lead to optimization. It's like in taxation. It's not very high rates of taxes which optimize tax collection by the government. It's the rational rates of taxes which optimize tax collection for the government. So I think similarly in natural resources, there has to be an optimum way of working.
Mr. Godrej, at the same time, while the Supreme Court has in a sense given more power to the executive, it's also a case of greater responsibility, because it has made it clear that if there is any allocation which is done in an arbitrary manner, the court can intervene. So with power also comes that additional responsibility, where we've seen that in the past there have been many cases, whether it is in the case of coal allocation or in the case of T2G, where transparent policies were not followed. Here on, at least, can we see the government ensuring that there will be transparent policy making, which will make it absolutely clear to all stakeholders what the methodology as far as allocation is going to be?
Yes, even if it's not auction, whatever methodology is adopted should be transparent and fair. That's what CII also represented. That's been upheld by the Supreme Court. And I think that's a very good development, because that will ensure that everything that is done in an open and fair manner, and that corruption will be eliminated.
Mr. Godrej, CII has clearly maintained that when it comes to coal block allocations, cancellation of those coal block licenses is something which will not go down very well when it comes to the overall economic development of the country. Keeping today's Supreme Court opinion in mind and the developments we've seen over the last few days in terms of more details emerging of the arbitrary nature in which some of those allocations were done, what is your view as of now with regard to coal block allocations?
Well, I'm not sure that all the allocations were done in an arbitrary manner. I think that should be looked into. I think the CBI is investigating. If allocations were done in an arbitrary manner, then of course intervention is required. Or if the agreements entered to have not been implemented as the agreements required implementation to be, then of course again intervention can be possible. But the call by some people to arbitrarily cancel all the coal block allocations, CII has said it's arbitrary and that should not be resorted to. Anything arbitrary, Shweta, is bad. Anything transparent, fair and with the backing of the law is what it should be.
All right, and we do really hope that today's path-breaking opinion will bring about that much-needed transparency. Mr. Adi Godrej, President of CII, many thanks for joining us and sharing your views. Let me now throw open the discussion to rest of the panelists, including my colleagues here.